Hi, Philip Chesney here from Agifall. For today's video, we're going to see how to create a wireframe. Now, first of all, what is a wireframe? A wireframe is a quick mock-up of a feature, functionality, website, or product. It will basically demonstrate how it should look and what it should do. Most of the time, and for the PMI ACP test, wireframes are low-fidelity prototyping. It is a great way to create a visual presentation for a team, customer, verbally present it, and then collect feedback on it. Let's look at an example. I have created a similar wireframe for a test simulator, basically very similar to PMI's online exam. Now, what I want you to see is how one slide flows into the next. This shows how the simulator should work. I also created slides that describe each of the features with short text. So our first slide here, we see current registered users. So we're gonna have two users here, our current ones and the new ones that sign up. So first, let's go with the current. We come to our welcome page, and up in the top, we're gonna add a login box. So our users will log in here. Now, once they're logged in, they will have choices of the simulators. So PMP simulator exams and exams 1 through 4. If they click on one of them, they'll get started with the exam. Now, once they start the exam, they'll have the countdown clock up here. So whether they have 3 hours or 4 hours to complete it, the number of questions. So for PMI ACP, there are 120 questions. For the PMP exam, there will be 200 questions. Each question has an ID number. So if we need to make any changes, or let's say someone made a grammar mistake, that can be adjusted in the back end. This part here, this is our question text. And then we have a multiple choice answer, and only one answer of the four can be correct. Now for our buttons down below, the mark saves the question until the end for review, so you can go back and solve it. For our next part, end exam. When you click end exam, you'll get a pop-up asking if you're ready to finish the test. The pop-up looks like this, end exam, and then the text here. So you can either end it or then go back to the exam. Once I click end exam, it'll present me with a score. So I scored 88 correct out of 120, and then click review exam to see your results. In this part here, we're actually going over the exam. So once you finish the full test, you can review answers for each question along with a textual explanation. So we had answer A, which would have been this one, and then its explanation. And then we can click the previous or the next, or then we can actually end the review. Now, if we have new users onto the simulator, here is the flow. How new users sign up. The new users can sign up via call to actions on the home screen, products page, about page. Now, all of these CTAs will bring you to the sign up screen. The sign up screen looks like this. So they can either sign up through Facebook or through LinkedIn. So basically just name, last name, email, password, and then which course they're signing up for. Now, once you insert that information, you still need to check your email to confirm it. Now, the email looks like this. So, time to verify and start practicing. So, basically, the student just needs to click to start the exam practice. Now, once the student clicks this, they will get this subsequent email. So, welcome to Agifall. Now, we have a video here that presents how to use the simulator. And if you're ready to start taking the exams, click the link below. This will bring them to the login page and then subsequently back to the simulator area. So then they can pick which exam they would like to take. In this video, I created it in PowerPoint, but there are quite a few programs you can use. Some of the options are Visio, InDesign, Wireframe.cc, mockups, UX pin, and many others. You could even just grab a pad and paper or a Sharpie marker and a whiteboard and start designing. If you use the last two methods, make sure to take a picture of your work in case it gets lost. Remember, for low fidelity prototypes, you're not looking for a beautiful design. You're just trying to convey how it should work, basically describing it visually than verbally. A few more reasons we should use wireframing is that it is a great way to test an idea and it can be created very quickly, and it helps us learn what the product should look like and how it should work. We are really looking to discuss the feature or product here and validate it with our team and or customer. The great part about wireframes are that they help decrease the gulf of evaluation. In other words, let's say that you want my company to build you a sailboat. You already have an idea in your mind of what it should do, look like, and have a certain expectation. For my team, we may understand something completely different. Wireframes help us get to the bottom of things and align expectations. With a well-thought-out wireframe, you can decrease rework and deliver the desired product or service the first time around. I hope that you've liked today's video and that you'll be able to put it into practice. Stay tuned for more PM videos and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. If you're getting ready to take your PMP or PMI ACP exam, check out the articles on getting certified.